don't know if I could catch the rhythm. Ooh, making me made it on myself.
Forgot the words.
So what do you please?
Nobody else.
Y'all don't know nothing about that old Deborah Cox bitch from the motherfucking The Morning After album. Y'all don't know about that bitch. All y'all know is about the remix album and the Nobody's Supposed to Be Here. Y'all don't know about that nasty Deborah Cox bitch. But I just got in here and finished watching The Hustle and Soul. We finna get right on into it. Anna and Lawrence. I'm not even gonna speak too much on them tonight because Lawrence kind of pissed me off and rubbed me the wrong way tonight. But we're gonna talk about that later. Cola, you can't be that dumb to the point as to where John walks in and you act as if, I know I look stupid with these glasses on, y'all. Oh well. You can't be that dumb as to how John walks in and you act like there's not an issue. You real zesty. Coca-Cola. I don't know. I think you Dominican too. I don't know if it's Dominican in you. You know, y'all start out zesty. Y'all mama let y'all start shaking y'all titties and y'all pussy at an early age. There I go cussing. Y'all mamas let y'all start shaking y'all stuff at an early age. You know how that. You know how y'all do. Y'all gets to it at an early age. Y'all start shaking y'all stuff at a young age, honey. But you and John being all hugged up when. Did I say John? You and Twin being all hugged up when John walked in. And then you acted like it was no big deal. But I was so glad that John and Twin were able to resolve any issues that they had. Because Twin was like, listen, yo, I was just... She came over there to me. I was just trying to get me some pussy. What's up? It wasn't nothing but a smash to me. I want y'all to be great. It was just a hit and run for me. And that's really what homeboy was trying to say. And I'm glad that y'all moved on. Because John, you is fine. So fine. So fine. Sandy, you a damn fool. You just a damn fool. I don't see it for you. I don't like you, Beetlejuice. You ugly as fuck. I don't like you. And that's the bottom fucking line. You a damn fool. You the fool of this show. Anna, you couldn't find anything cheaper than a $3 million home in Miami, girl. Damn, you just got the man back. Well, barely. But you know, you got his foot in the door and you gonna try to get that man to buy a $3 million house? Girl, babe, you could have made $100,000 house, but I guess Miami house is down there in Miami high sale. Cola, you chilling with the twins, like with Twin on purpose, like on the plane, rub me the wrong way, like. I don't know what, I guess it's just the Dominican in you. You real spicy flavor, like, you know, and I like spicy. I really like hot wings. I eat them almost every other day. I go get me a 10-pound bag of boneless chicken and I make me hot wings every other day. So I like it spicy, but you know, John, and I mean, y'all is in an open relationship. So I guess You know, I don't know. I wanted, did he go out and smash somebody? I'm sure he did with his fine ass. So, when I seen Dandy walking out to the motherfucking party, I was like, huh? Where the fuck did you come from, Dandy? What made you think this was okay? But see, the way Cola attitude was, I thought Anna was gonna jump on you, but the way Cola was, Cola was getting them licks in that motherfucking pool, bitch. See, that's zesty. Zesty. That's that zestiness in her, that Dominican in her. She's zesty. I'm telling you, she got that spice. That Latino flavor, baby. That hot sauce on her. She got it going on. I like Cola, you know, and she was getting them licks in, bitch. Beetlejuice, you really didn't get no licks in. Cola was getting them licks in that water, bitch, and you was like, she went. She had it going on, Cola, and I'm here for it because I don't fucking like Dandy. So, Dandy, and it's got to be you because everybody got an issue with you. Everybody got an issue with you. That's my problem. The crew was not really here for you showing up, and everything just went wrong down to that beach house or the pool house or whatever you want to call it. But I didn't understand why Lawrence was trying to fight John John. I didn't really think that John John was trying to escalate the fight. Maybe I missed that scene because I did turn my head for what I was, you know. But I didn't think he was trying to escalate the fight. Maybe I missed it. Maybe I need to go back and watch it. The next day, them waking up and them not responding back to the text I got, because I was like, okay, them motherfuckers probably drunk, passed out, hungover somewhere. But y'all not showing up to the cook-off, like, yeah, I wasn't really here for that, because that's y'all manager and he was the one who flew y'all out here when he really only could have flown Anna out here. And for y'all to do that, not even show up to the cook-off, and then y'all excuse was y'all was trying to disavoid the drama. I'm sure there would have been no drama at the cook-off. Whatever. I don't know. Lawrence, you going in the Dandy room and getting in that tub with her, you rubbed me the wrong way tonight too. I don't know. I don't see it for you. Like, huh? Like, hmm? I'm still trying to wrap my head around it, because, and then you got in there and I'm sure y'all fucked or whatever. You fucked Beetlejuice. Dandy, you are just crazy, because basically what you really told him was, I want you to be with me no matter what. Basically what you were saying was, I will be the side bitch, but I want you to be committed to me. Like, I don't understand the way people be thinking these days. They be like, oh yeah, like, I'm okay with you being over there, but you gotta be with me at the same time too. Like, what? No, motherfucker, if you can't be over here the whole time, you take your ass to work and you bring your motherfucking ass home. And that's the bottom line. Lawrence, you a hoe too. I'm done with you. Dandy, you full of shit. You, Dandy, you just a old tapper. I can't go that high the way Squeak did it, but you know, y'all know where I was trying to get at. My voice don't really go that high. My voice go down here. I can't go like, I don't be doing all that. I did like that Dandy was invited to the cook-off and she had a positive energy until she saw Lawrence kiss Anna. Like, Dandy, Lawrence just does not see it for you like that. You just a jump-off girl, okay? Like, know your role, know your spot. You not that girl to be doing all of that kind of stuff. Like, you just a hit-and-run girl. You know, you remember that song Little Kim made, I been going for a minute, now I'm back at the jump off? That's what you are. You the jump off girl. And I don't really know where I picked this little New York accent up tonight. This little ghetto-ass accent. But it's only for this video. I promise y'all. You just a piece of meat, Thandi, and that's all it is. Like, get that in your head. Like, you not that girl. You not... He don't really want to marry you. You just a piece of meat. And we clearly see on the episode who he clearly wanted to get engaged to. But you gonna spill the tea and say that he got in your lopsided ass pussy. I don't trust you. I don't trust no bitch that dye her hair red with a Kool-Aid pack. Hell no, nah, look like you took a whole lot of red, them strawberry Kool-Aid packs, and put it on top of your head, and then braided it, and then tried to holler about you, you trying to do it for the Afrikeesha girls. Nah, bitch, you ain't trying to do it for no Afrikeesha girls. Your edge is just bad, bitch. Your hair fell out, and then you try to... Is that weave she had on? Nah, she had on a weave in the last episode. I just don't like you, Thandi, so I'ma toy everything you got going on. It's dirty in my damn fingernails. Anyways, that's all I really got for Hustling. So this was a tired ass episode as far as he got popping on into the house. But other than that, wasn't too much going off besides Cola hitting them licks. And I'm glad she got that Muppet. Wrong show. I'm glad that she got Beetlejuice ass together. But speaking of Muppet, I'm about to get out of here. I'm about to give y'all the motherfucking Braxton Family Values review. Make sure you like and subscribe. Drop down in the comments and let me know what did you think of this episode of Hustling. So whose side were you on? Were you on Cola's side? Were you on Thandi's side? What did you think about Thandi just showing up to the motherfucking trip? And did you think that workers were wrong for not supporting him at the competition? I think they were. But let me know what you guys think. Bye.